Good afternoon. A 4-year-old Urbandale boy knew just what to do when his mom suddenly became unconscious.
We go right to Keri, Gavin with the 911 call that'll give you goosebumps.
Eric and Stacy, it's a parent's job to protect their children, but in this case, it was the other way around.
1:15 Thursday afternoon, Polk County dispatcher Maggie Broder gets a call.
Polk County Sheriff's Office.
My mommy doesn't feel good.
The call was from a cell phone, so dispatchers didn't have an immediate address.
Where is your mommy?
She's at Iowa.
Where? Yes, I know where Iowa is.
But the boy didn't know what town he was in.
Mommy?
Who else is there with you besides
me? He's passed out right now.
The call, not nearly as surprising as what unfolded before him and his age.
He's not feeling good. He's going to drink some juice, but...
How old are you?
Passed out.
How old are you?
Four. Yeah.
As dispatchers tried to ping the cell phone to determine the location, Broder continued to ask questions.
What color house do you have?
It's white.
What color door does your house have?
I'll go check if it's brown, okay? I'll be right back.
No, well, don't hang up.
I'll come up there and see if it's brown, okay?
Okay, you go, but you could take the phone with you.
For 15 minutes, he stayed on the phone, at times showing his tender age.
Do you hear the siren?
A bad guy's coming.
No, the good guys are coming. They're going to come and help your mommy.
Oh.
With no exact location, the boy saw the emergency crews, but they didn't see him.
They're right there by somebody's house.
Okay, you go and yell at them. Go outside and say, hey, I'm over here.
And he listened, continuing to handle the scary situation with courage and grace.
I'm over here. I'm over here. Our mommy's in trouble.
Did you call the 911?
Yeah, let me talk to him.
Let me talk to him.
Today we also talked with the Polk County dispatcher who took the call. She says she's taken thousands of calls in her 17 years of service, but never one like this.
Oh, he's amazing. I mean, I know four-year-olds that can't talk, let alone carry on a full conversation and know that they need help.
Coming up tonight on News Channel 8 at 6, the dispatcher walks us through the call as she desperately tried to keep the 4-year-old on the phone. It's an exciting story that you'll have to stay tuned for.
Oh my gosh, what a sweet little boy.
Absolutely.
How is his mom, Keri?
Well, she did require immediate medical attention, but she is doing just fine today.
Okay. Thank you.